We have finally done it. In the Youth Academy Challenge Save, we have moved into our new stadium and we played our first match there. Since we moved in, we've only had one match in the stadium, but we've finished the entirety of the summer transfer window, so let's go over that, shall we? I should start talking about the sales, and Marcin Litka has left us for Lech Poznan. They offered a decent fee for him as far as I was concerned, 2.8 million to be exact, and they're starting him. I wasn't going to start him, and he's kind of falling out of the pecking order, but the offer came in, I couldn't turn it down, so I took it. I finally sold Jacka Salinski for £2.5 million to LKS Lutz, and honestly, I think I've done well here to get £2.5 million for someone I was loaning out for the last few seasons. Apparently, he's made such a reputation for himself that he was actually worth that much money to a side that is trying to avoid relegation. Says a lot, doesn't it? Now, this is a loan, but we made £1.1 million from this loan, and David Wablowski is at Legia Warsaw. The fact we're now able to loan players to Legia Warsaw is saying a lot, and I still can't believe they're willing to pay £1 million for him, even if they're not playing him. Imagine if they loan him and don't play him at all. Imagine if they loan him for £1 million and don't even play him. It would just be very ironic, wouldn't it? But still, he's a leading player for the division, so why wouldn't they use him? Sorinsky's left us on a free to Victoria Plzeň. I let his contract expire and he's now gone. He's had 4 games in the Czech Premier League in the Fortuna Liga. He's now wanted by Lille on loan, apparently, and I don't know how I feel about it. Michal Smolik has also left us. He's gone to Real Zaragoza. He left us for 2.8 million and he's already looking to leave because he's concerned about being replaced. They spent 2.8 million on this guy and they've already made him feel like he's being replaced. Am I scamming these clubs? I'm starting to feel like I'm scamming these clubs out of their money. Michal Oswinski is out on loan to Ruchahuf. He was in the second tier last year on loan. He's now in the top tier this year on loan. He's already played 4 times. We are getting about £500,000 for him. And for a loan deal, that's not bad. He's a good player for the division. He needs experience. And he's getting it here at a team in the top flight. So, happy days. I'm also now loaning players to the Championship in England because, well, Sozinski is out on loan to Reading. He's apparently got potential to be a star player for the division and he's a leading player now. He's played 4 times in the Championship and has been absolutely woeful. So, have they made a mistake? They're not paying any loan fee or anything, so it's not the end of the world, I suppose, but I'm just shocked. He's played every single game for them and they've not just kicked him out yet. The fact they're in 12th and they've won twice with him being that bad is surprising to me, but okay. But yes, we've actually made £11 million in transfers going out and some loans as well. So, kind of shocking that's the case. I didn't think I can get this sort of money, but here we are. So now, let's talk about the matches. The first game we had was a Super Pohopalski final. We beat Gornik Zabrze by 3-0. Davidovic with all 3 goals. He's starting off his season in a wonderful manner. The next game we had was against Lech Poznan and we drew 0-0. Despite the fact they had just 1 shot in the entire match and we had 27. Admittedly, 7 were on target, 10 were off target, which means another 10 were blocked. And their goalkeeper was really good. And they were also down to 10 men for the last 25 minutes. Can I feel disappointed by this? I feel like I should be disappointed. Well, at least the next game against Cracovia was nice. We beat them by 3-0. And we haven't officially moved into the new stadium yet. So, this is the last time we're taking on Cracovia in the league at home. We absolutely dominated them as well. So, it's not like it was a fluke either. We're just really good now. We then took on Podgorica Kislya and beat them 2-0. Kimmich with a brace. And we looked good. I think they had a shot early on that gave me concern. But once we got over that hump, we took control of the game and started to do well. So, another good win. Then we took on Jagiellonia and drew 1-1. I must confess, when we took the lead, I left because I thought, oh, I'll be fine. I won't have to worry about anything. Came back, found it was 1-1. No idea how they scored, but they did. And then we didn't do anything at all. And this is the last game we had against them. At home. Jagiellonia our pain. Two shots on target, one goal. Absolutely frustrating this. That was the last game we had at home, and we then followed it up with a 0-0 draw against Lega Warsaw, because of course we would. Honestly, I feel like I'm just asking for trouble at this point when I make fun of these teams. Well, at least we haven't lost. But then we had our first game in our new stadium and we absolutely decimated Wushahoof. And yeah, I'm happy with this result. Really, really happy. Even if our lonely couldn't play in this game, we were strong and they had just one shot on target, one shot on goal. It didn't do anything of note, and we won by 3-0. Binecki started because of an injury to Davidovic, and he got a brace, so clearly he's good for something. And I'm going to show you the screen because I think it's fascinating. This stadium can be expanded to 35,000, so that's exciting. And I think I might start doing that at some point in the season. I don't know how long it'll be before I really start thinking about doing it, but I might even ask before the end of the season if we can expand it. Because we know we've got an extra 11,000 seats here. Why not utilize that? We're in third. We've drawn 3 times, which is a lot for us. This is more times than we've drawn any other time in recent times. And we've only conceded 1 goal. And it was against Jacolonia who drew against us. So that's slightly awkward. And the fact we didn't beat Lech Warsaw or Lech Poznań is frustrating. But when we win comfortably. So at least we got that. We're also 3 points behind the league leaders, Cracovia, who we beat 3-0. So at least we know we can win against the bigger teams and the league leaders, right? Right? But still, this is the Champions League draw. We didn't even have to play qualifiers this year, and that is a relief. It's been so long since I've actually had the honour of not having to worry about that. But yes, here we are. Braga is our first game. We are taking on them at home. Then we take on the Swedish team, Gais? How do you say his name? I don't actually know how to say his team's name. But then we go away to Monaco, host Dortmund, go to Inter, go to Den Haag, and then we host Sociedad and take on Bayern Munich. I'm going to say it's on a whim. There should be at least 3 wins here against Braga, Gais, and Den Haag. I think we can get a result against Dortmund, Inter, Sociedad, and Monaco. I'm just not sure about Bayern Munich. And I know that's very ambitious of me to say all those teams apart from Bayern Munich are winnable, but I truly believe that now. We are definitely getting better and better, and we need to take the next step. Having failed to get out of the group stage last year and having been to the round of 16 at best, we need to start making the steps towards getting to quarterfinal at the bare minimum. And with a new stadium, that might be useful. Finances, we have got £195.4 million in the bank, which honestly means I could just ask about standing the stadium right now. But I'm going to wait until Christmas, I think, before I consider asking about it, because I want to see where we are financially, because we are good now. We are so comfortable that even though the projection says we're going to lose a lot of money, we are not going to lose money in the slightest, and we should be fine. The fact that 3 years ago we only had 103 million really tells you just how much we've improved the infrastructure of the club financially and just how much we could really splash the cash if we really decided to go down that route. The fact I could just literally spring up £100 million to spend on players if I really want to go down that route says it all, doesn't it? That being said, I should really look at the teams in Europe and if any other Polish teams made it, because I know at least one team didn't make it through, and that is disappointing. In the Europa League, Lech Warsaw made it through, which means we have missed out Górnik Zabrze, who might be down in the Conference League. I actually need to check this to be certain. Yes, they are. And they're also the only Polish team in the group stage, which means that Lech Poznań got eliminated, as did Wisla Kraków, which is a bit of a shock, because Kraków looked like they were doing well. And I'm hoping that isn't just because of a bad result. So I'm looking back at the Europa League, and I realised that Lech Warsaw almost threw it away because of a red card early on, and they had to come from 2-0 down to make it 2-1 to actually go through overall to make it 3-2, which is a bit frustrating. I swear there's another Polish team in this round. Yes, Górnik Zabrze, Utrecht, they are very lucky to have lost that game. Okay. They lost the first leg by 2-1, and they took the lead too. So that's a frustrating situation there. They got to the playoffs and they lost. As for the Conference League, Irish were Vista Crackers opponents. They drew 2-2 in Greece and actually came from 2-0 down to get their draw. But then they just were beaten 3-2 in Poland to be knocked out, which is a shame. The less I said about Lech Poznan as a result, which is a 4-0 result at home, and then was a 2-1 defeat away, the better, honestly. It just frustrates me. In the third quarterfinal round too, for goodness sake. So, as things stand, we've only got 2.3 points this year in the coefficients, but we are losing our worst year. As things stand, we will still, at the moment, be making up 2 places that we might be concerned with other things happening. Switzerland are now starting to have a good year, and we just hope that Belgium and Liechtenstein do not have good years this year, and it looks like Liechtenstein might have already lost their representative in the European stages, which is absolutely lovely if that's the case. They did. Venezia did them a massive favour by knocking out Vedez, and Novi Pazar knocked them out of the Europa League, so that's wonderful stuff. Liechtenstein are going to have a terrible year this year. So hooray for that! At least there's one less nation to worry about this season. I just now need to worry about Switzerland and Belgium. I just hope we don't lose a place, or if at the bare minimum we can at least get 2 places. At least 1 place we're getting so far. I want it to be 2 at the bare minimum now. Anyway, what I'm going to do is end this here. I hope you guys have enjoyed yourselves. I hope you guys will like and share this video. And that you'll subscribe to the channel. It really does help me out a lot. What do you think of our season so far? And how well do you think we'll do in Europe? I want to hear thoughts and opinions and all that down below. But anyway, until next time, goodbye and well, good night.